congratulations. Please start us off with an opening statement.
Yeah, I mean, before I talk about our team, I just want to say, you know, credit to Oakland. You know, Jeff Tungate's one of my really good friends, and, you know, he's been out most of the season, which is really hard for us coaches that, you know, care about our teams and as much as we invest. And, you know, his program, Keisha, they've gotten better throughout the year. We played them at our place. They gave us an 8-point game, and it's a credit to them and their program as they've gotten better over the years. So, you know, I think you're going to see big things from Oakland in the future. As far as our team, you know, offensively, we were really good the entire game. We weren't great defensively in the first quarter, but after that, we kind of got locked in. And, you know, obviously these two up here played very well.
All right, we'll open up for questions for the players. Anyone have questions for the players?
Yep.
Cody Emerson, Journal Review. Macee was looking up some records today, and specifically the field goal percentage record. He went 13 of 14 today, which as of your guys' weapon would break the singles game field goal percentage record. And I know your name has been littered throughout the record books, but it just feels probably good to add another one today, and especially in such a dominating win for you.
Well, honestly, I didn't realize, I guess, I was even close to that type of record. I didn't even know there was a record like that. And, I mean, it's awesome to have my name out there. But, I mean, I got to give it up to my teammates. They always look for me when I'm open, and they do such a good job of passing me the ball. So, I mean, all those records are credited to them. So.
That's why I didn't put you in it, once you're below.
Yep.
For both players, you've been pointing toward winning a conference championship and tournament championship for a long time in the back of your mind. But now it's the chances here. How good is it now to finally have it in front of you right there?
Do you want this? Okay. I mean, it feels really good. I mean, this whole season we really put ourselves in a good position. I know we had some, backfire with the forfeits and stuff, but I mean, we didn't really let those get to us. So, I mean, we really put ourselves in a good position.
I mean, we've been taking it one game at a time the entire season. We've been focusing on little things, like every practice, trying to get better, every game we play. So to just have the goal, like, here right in front of us, it's something special. And with this team, it's, like, something that we can actually see, like, come into fruition.
Any other questions for the players?
A little bit more on the emotions of that. I think one of the last times I got to see you guys was 2 years ago when the tournament was being canceled. You guys were flying high, and you've had to take it one game at a time since then. So tomorrow it's in front of you. Walk me through the emotions, I guess, of a chance to win another championship, but also your headspace going into that.
A lot on the line of being in the championship again, but just from winning 2 years ago and not being able to actually go into the NCAA, it's a little more motivation, and, like, it's kind of nice because Holly is on the coaching staff, so it's kind of like I also want her to experience that, even though she's not actually playing. But, I mean, it's for the other people who don't actually get to play on the team, as, like, Taylor. So it's like I kind of want to do it for them. And just, I mean, there's still a lot on the line, so, I mean, taking it, so.
Putting up a second to season high in points, what allowed you guys, both of you can answer this if you want, just allowed you to, Macee, you talked about feeding off your teammates. What just allowed you as a team to just click today offensively? Because 59% from the field, and just to put up a season, or almost a season high in points. You guys were just seemed clicking on all levels.
Go ahead, Richard.
I think we knew what we were playing for tonight, and because it meant so much to us, we just came out with that mentality of, like, we were gonna take it, and we always know that, like, when one of us is down, someone else is going to pick us up. So, like, Macee's kind of like our solid foundation, and she just played so well, and everyone else feeds off of her. I know she said she feeds off of us, but it's the same way. So we just, yeah, like you said, I guess we just clicked today.
Any more questions for the players? Thanks, ladies. Appreciate the time. All right, we'll now open it up for questions for Coach Parkinson.
Yeah, I think right here.
Right here.
Along that same line what we talked about earlier, how good is it now to be able to talk about winning the championship when it is right there in front of you?
Yeah, I mean, we have one more game. I think there was a lot of stress that went into this season. I'll talk more about that later, is just the forfeits that took place. And so, when we were able to kind of clinch the one seed and put ourselves in this position, we've been here now 3 years in a row. Last year, it was in front of cardboard cutouts, which was a different deal, to say the least. So it was actually really cool for the kids today, with the fans there and the support. It felt like a tournament feel. And I can just tell our kids are really focused. We won the regular season championship. They were excited, but this is what they want to play for, and we're going to have to play really well to do it. Nobody's going to hand us anything, so we're going to have to go out tomorrow and hopefully defend a little better than we did today, and that'll be beneficial if we want to win.
Right up front here.
Coach, more about, Macee just really started to establish herself early, and I know she's done that a lot for you all year, to see your best players step up at this point in the season when you know that everything's at stake has to give you a lot of confidence going out there as a coach to know that you're going to get the best out of both Macee, Rachel, and your leaders as you prepare to hopefully win another championship.
Yeah, I mean, anytime if you win a championship, your best players got to be your best players. So, those three were really good tonight, but. Macee, you could tell had a bounce in her step tonight, was really efficient. We don't take that for granted. But I also want to say our players did a good job of looking for her and finding her. She has such great hands, so she makes some unbelievable catches. But, we played Oakland at our place, and we just talked about sometimes we get in these little, I wouldn't call them funks, but where we don't make a point to really get her the basketball. And when she has it, good things happen, because whether it's a kick-out shot or a post move, and tonight it happened to be, her making moves on the blocks.
Questions for Coach? Yep.
What's the message you send to the locker room? Do you have to say anything to this locker room, knowing that, they've been playing for this moment again for 2 years?
Really, no. No, there's nothing I need to say. I mean, they'll be ready to play tomorrow. They're a very motivated group. I've been 12 years, and when you coach a team, not every kid, when you recruit kids, everybody talks about how much they love the game of basketball. Oh, I love basketball. Oh yeah, I love it. And then they get to college, and practice is over, and they're the first to, they don't stay around and get shots up, and they're not watching film with the coaches. Like, this team has a group of players that are highly, highly invested, spend time after practice. I mean, I can guarantee they'll go back today to the hotel and watch the game on ESPN Plus on their own. I mean, that's not something we've really had where you have not just a few players but a majority of your players with that mindset. So there's not much I need to say tomorrow. I mean, they know they're going to have to play well, and one of these two teams is you're going to be a challenge for us. So, we're going to have to guard, and I just know that they're looking forward to it.
Any more questions for Coach? Great. Thanks, Coach. Appreciate the time.
Thank you.
See you back here tomorrow.
Appreciate it.